Hello guys, what is up? It is Finn here, bringing you guys some more NHL 19 Failure Friday. I hope everyone is having a marvelous Friday. Let's see if we can hit 200 likes this episode. I know we can do it. So go ahead, hit that like button, show that love and support, and subscribe. Join the Dorsal family and help us get closer to 100K before the end of the summer. And also, don't forget to hit that bell, turn on notifications, and follow us on Twitch if you guys would like to see the videos live before they go up on YouTube. One last thing, if you guys have any clips, make sure to submit them to nhlfailurefriday@gmail.com. And for MLB Failure Friday, make sure to submit them to mlbfailurefriday@gmail.com. All right, now that I got that all out of the way, let's go ahead and take a look at our first submission. Alright, so this is a pretty weird glitch with the mouth guard in this game. Kind of weird. But yeah, let's go ahead and take a look at this. Watch his mouth guard and his face. They, like, enlarge. Look at this. And it looks like his cheeks kind of puff out a little bit, too. It's weird. I don't know what's going on with that, but he's having some issues with that mouth guard. Very, very, very odd. So possibly a very questionable no call here, as it looks like the goalie was interfered with and maybe this goal should not have counted. Now take a look at this. So he gets pushed. Now I'm not sure if this didn't count because maybe the defenseman pushed him into the net, or maybe it kind of looks like the game might have registered it as the defenseman might have knocked it in. It was kind of hard to tell, but yeah, I'm not quite sure how that goal counted, because it did kind of look like he was interfered with, so maybe the opposing player was pushed in by a member of the Leafs, which is, you know, a good goal. So maybe it was a good goal call, I'm not sure, but I don't know. Very odd. I will say, though, after looking at it again, it does look like that it should have been a goal call, because It did look like a Maple Leaf pushed him into the goalie, but it's all a matter of how the game registered it, you know what I mean? But after looking at it again, it does look like it was no interference, so I think it was just bad luck there. Alright, so in this next clip, definitely not a very good time to kick the puck, and not a very good place to kick it too. Take a look at this. This defender goes ahead, turns around, and kicks it right back to a member of the opposing team. They cross-crease it for a goal. Ouch. Well, I gotta say, this was a pretty nice celebration. I gotta give it to him for the dedication. Take a look at this. Tries to go past Koskinen and takes out the net just so he can get to his teammate. I love that. Way to go, man. And he gets there, too. Alright, so this next clip is quite long, but man, is it an interesting one, as we have a 200-foot goal, but with some help. Take a look.
This is what happens when you do a lot of AI versus AI simulations. You get a lot of funny moments. This is going to look slightly similar to the clip that Finn actually just put in episode 30, Failure Friday, involving Vasilevsky versus Senators. It's pretty much the same thing, but it's going to be a little different this time. Of course, you already know what's going to happen. The puck's going to go off the skate and into the net. But the difference here is that Jesper Fast never actually touches the puck. So what does this mean? This is a 200-foot goal by Mark Stahl, who is on his way to the bench and then suddenly is counted for a goal. Pretty nice. So yeah, watch this again from Stahl. He's the one who chipped it. Okay, it went all the way down. You already saw that. It makes its way into the net right before Stahl goes off, and he's still on the ice to celebrate. My question is, if he went on the bench and that goal was counted, would he celebrate on the bench? Also, another thing, this guy's leg is going right through the boards. Hello, Brady. Three fails in one video. That is absolutely not Brady Shea. All right, see ya.
Yeah, not quite sure what was going on there, but you gotta love when you get a 200-foot goal. It might not be the cleanest 200-foot goal. You did have some help there, but I love it. Really nice clip. Thank you for submitting that. And we had a couple extra fails in there too, which was pretty cool. All right, so this next one is actually from the same guy as the last one. And this was a pretty interesting behind the net goal with a very little effort. Take a look.
All right, so this might not be the most impressive clip if you even accept it, because this is in practice mode and I'm just trying out with my new sliders what kind of shots work 1-on-0. I don't mean breakaways, maybe just odd man rushes, but instead of passing, you take the shot. I'm not sure if goaltenders try to anticipate passes in this game. Anywho, I figured out a trick to doing wraparounds, and I just did one with Connor McDavid. So I'm trying it out here with Patrick Laine, and I go to do it, but I accidentally shoot it. But it doesn't really matter. And it's honestly really hard to pull this off. I pull the Sidney Crosby. Yeah, it's in practice mode, but still pretty impressive. Off the back of him and in.
That's the beauty of hockey. Sometimes you score goals in ways that surprise yourself. It happens to me all the time, especially in franchise mode. But it is quite an awesome thing to experience, I must say. All right, so this might be the greatest goal of all time. This was just spectacular. You guys have to see this. Take a look at this.
And down to Powell. And snap to James. He throws it there. Score!
All right, so let's watch this replay because that was something else. So take a look at this. When he shoots it, it goes off the defender's stick. And since it's on an angle, it just goes straight up in the air. Goalie probably has no clue what's going on. And it just goes right on past him. Man, you have to hate that if you're just anyone on the opposing team. Especially the goalie. The goalie's probably like, what was I supposed to do there? You know what I mean? I mean, I guess he could have been a little further back, but how is he supposed to know where it was going, you know? But yeah, that's a big bummer there. But still, an awesome clip if you're the offense. So trying to get the game tied up. This is actually another clip from this guy who has two others in this video. So this guy's killing it this episode. Take a look at this.
I don't know why, but I'm kind of borderline impressed by this. Okay, so here's the story right now. Minnesota's up 1-0. There's literally 10 seconds left in the clock. I've made every strategy on the Sharks full aggressive to try to get this game tied. Still my turtle. Great pass to Couture. Slap shot. That rebound looks like, ooh, Dumna gets it, and yikes. For the first time ever, I've seen an AI take a goaltender interference penalty. I'm going to assume it's because the puck entered the net as a result of a goalie collision. So 2.3 seconds left, the Wild have a power play. And this is actually the closest game I've seen with these sliders, and I've gotten 7-4 games with them. So I guess that's pretty cool.
Well, at least you had a pretty close game. But, I mean, I've gotten goaltender interference calls quite often with me playing against the AI, and I've also had the AI interfere with my goalie. I mean, I've seen it both ways, so I'm kind of surprised you haven't, but maybe we just play on different slider sets or game settings, who knows, but yeah, the game can be a little inconsistent like that nonetheless, but don't know if that puck was going to go in if he hadn't gotten pushed, Dubnyk, but yeah, it kind of stinks to get your hopes up like that for sure. Alright guys, so here we go. This is going to be the last clip for this week's episode. And the goalie wanted to help out a little bit. Take a look at this. Player misses the net, and then it goes off the skate of Ben Bishop, sliding across the line, but he just did enough to help out. Not sure if that player that finished it off got credit with the goal there, or if it went to the guy that originally shot it. I'm not 100% sure who got credit for it, but Bishop definitely played a killer part nonetheless. But guys, that is going to do it for this one. I hope you all enjoyed. Thank you all so much for watching. Also, tomorrow at 3 p.m. Eastern time, I will be uploading game... hold on, I gotta remember what game it is. I think it is game 5 of the World Series. I will be uploading tomorrow in our Phillies franchise at 3 p.m. Eastern time, so be on the lookout for that. And also, I do plan to get up a dorsal fin with either the Capitals or Columbus, depending on what team won the vote. So wanted to let you guys know that. Not sure if I'll upload that on Saturday or Sunday. Most likely Sunday, but we shall see. But guys, thank you all so much for watching. I hope you all enjoyed. Don't forget to submit your clips to NHL Failure Friday thebeatdownpod@gmail.com. And don't forget to leave a like and subscribe. And as always, I will see you guys in the next one. Peace.